That is one custom setup there. I mean,
so if you're ever incarcerated in, say, a foreign country after being adrift, would you maybe count on someone to shoot you apart?
Will it break your wrists and your arms?
Now, this video is inspired by Edward Sarkisian's video of him trying to shoot a pair of handcuffs apart with different guns. But would it injure the person who has the handcuffs on him? And can we do it differently with a more powerful, exotic brass shotgun slug?
For official police use.
Yeah, not any of that unofficial police use, like what happens at home on the weekends. And I'll tell you, folks, there's no way any police officer would use these things.
They're pretty...
they're made out of metal. I will give you that they're made out of metal.
They're not bad.
They're pretty sharp.
They're $24.
Yeah, I tell you what.
How much are regular ones?
About $18 for those knives over there.
What?
Yeah, I think I
need
ripped
to shop
off.
Around a little better.
I think these are the ones for sale.
I pay more for fake ones.
This is one down at the toy aisle, I think. The dollar store.
The surplus store.
They came with keys, so that's all that matters.
Yeah. Let's shoot those first. We got real ones too.
Yeah, I've got some good Peerless ones that I brought from work, and we'll shoot Jeff's Taiwanese police. Evidently, they got no muscle mass in Taiwan because...
These are official ones there?
Those are officials.
Okay, they're really similar.
Yeah.
Come on.
Sure. One can be broken and one cannot.
We'll see. It's double nickel plated.
Oh, well, there you go.
Double... Everything's nickel plated, apparently.
That's what you
Yeah, but that's
so
double nickel plated.
Double nickel plated, yeah.
You don't want that single nickel plated crap. Because it matters on your handcuffs.
Yeah, snowflakes can get out of that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
They're not bad. Come on.
All right. We'll see.
Put your hands in the air like you just don't care.
All right. Let's cuff them up.
Those are the cheap ones, right?
These are the Taiwanium.
Okay.
See, they
don't even, Dano.
They don't even do the proper police grip with these things because they're so stiff.
Book them.
Actually, I had them set this way so that you could get more room in between them.
There, nab it. That's very realistic.
Well, if you ever have a guy and a girl handcuffed together, Mr. and Mrs. Smith.
What do we want to find out here? We want to see if you can shoot the handcuffs off with a harder, exotic shotgun slug, like, you know, brass or steel. And if it'll hurt your wrists or break your arms in the process.
Well, then why are we using mannequin arms? We should have one of us up here.
Well, who's going to film and shoot it then?
You.
Oh. I'm glad you trust me. All right, what are we using first?
All right, we're going to use some of Tim's brass knuckles.
The ballistic machinist brass pellets.
Brass pellets.
Come on.
I like the brass knuckles.
I do too.
That's what you call them, brass balls.
Solid brass slug. 1700 feet per second approximately, and it's kind of a knuckle shaped. Fantastic, very accurate, and as we said before, these things will go through a rhinoceros.
A rhinosaurus?
Yes.
Front to back though, or side to side?
Through the thick part.
Mm.
Yeah. Let's see how that does. Let's see if we can hit that little chain.
Well, I think normally you would be doing this at like very close range. Like right up against the barrel, but what fun is that?
I don't know.
Make it into a sharpshooting contest.
I don't know if I'd want a shotgun going off close range to my wrist.
That's true. Yeah, that's a good point. The muzzle blast. Okay, Danny, take your time and see if you can hit that little chain. I'm ready. Gotta load one in there.
Firing blanks over there?
Yeah, pulling an Edwin here.
Okay, Clear. Danny.
Cabron!
Okay, I'm ready whenever you are.
Now, we didn't give Danny any practice shots. That was just, I guess this is his practice shot. And you can see the slug just grazed the bottom of the chain, shaved off some brass even, but just wasn't quite centered enough. So let's have him take another shot and see if he can do any better.
Okay, shot number two, brass pellet. Whenever you are ready.
There
Holy
you go.
Holy crap.
Taiwanesium.
Now this shot, the slug kind of went to the right, but it had enough energy just to tear that chain apart. And really, surprisingly, it didn't do much damage to the wrists or arms of the mannequin arms.
So this is the left arm, okay.
Not a lot of damage because the hasp was nice and tight. Pulled the chain right out of the middle. Vin Diesel, however, little damage to his wrist and bent the S out of this handcuff, so that would not have been fun to
have. Yeah, you could have.
Look at the brass transfer right there where it snapped right through there.
Wow. Okay. Well, those are the cheap ones. So let's see. Those would be a good Patreon giveaway too, don't you think?
I think so.
Are you doing the queen wave?
The parade wave, yeah.
So we have Peerless. These are the brand we use at work. And these are pretty high quality. This is what most officers choose over the department issued ones. So nice high quality ones. We'll see how they hold up versus the Taiwanium.
And how well the arms hold up too.
Sure.
You gonna do a little arm wrestling there?
I am. See if this will be the only time I can beat Vin Diesel in arm wrestling.
So you got like a man. And there's a man's arm and a woman's arm there. Where'd you get those at?
A girl named Elizabeth down at JCPenney's was gracious enough to donate those. I took them home and painted them up.
That was nice, man.
Yeah, she's pretty cool.
Okay, real official police.
Peerless.
Are these double nickel plated, though?
Well, these are just single nickel.
Okay.
We can't afford two nickels. That's just dime plated.
Okay, we're again with the brass pellet, beast of the slug. Okay, I'm ready. Take your time.
Oof, right in half.
Okay, see?
What?
No better than mine. No better than my $23 one.
Not versus a slug, no.
Look at the arms didn't even move.
Look at the chunk out of the forearm on Taylor Swift.
Now this is definitely the best shot with the tougher Peerless handcuffs. Well, supposedly tougher. The slug had no problem just slicing through those chains. It broke them like they were made out of plastic, and as you can see, the arms almost didn't even move. It was like a samurai sword, a very sharp one slicing through a rope or whatever.
Okay, what happened?
Manny, Magic Danny made that chain disappear.
Houdini. I know.
Shotgun Houdini.
It's like, did he hit it?
That's what I thought. I looked up and the arms didn't move and I thought I missed. But
chain evaporated. So first thing we saw downrange or back range was the hole in Taylor Swift's wrist. And turns out that is from the little aluminum wad that.
Yeah, it's a backing piece that goes behind the brass to support it.
And then exited right there, through and through.
The little aluminum piece has a lot of energy still.
Sorry, Taylor, shake it off.
But yeah, it just yanked that chain and tore it a new one. Okay, now a Guabo steel from Gualandi. Italian slugs, a steel slug. Let's see what it does to some handcuffs.
Ooh, wow. I think you definitely hit
the handcuffs. They went about 30 yards down there.
Now this is more of a bonus shot since we've already shot up both pairs of our handcuffs, but it gives you an idea how powerful a steel slug was. We did talk about shooting a brass and a steel slug, so we wanted to at least show you a steel slug in action.
Well, I can't believe you found all that stuff. That was a good shot. I mean, we didn't take a practice shot with those Guabo steels.
No, that was the first shot.
Cut her hand right off.
Pushed him right through there.
I definitely don't want to do it that way, in other words.
Danny's going to take this home.
I'm not gonna tell the wife. Look at that. Flatten the teeth in the ratchet.
This one's clearly too big.
Be careful, that's fiberglass. You can be all itchy.
Well, I got a hand to scratch myself with.
Okay. Not bad. I mean, it tore the handcuff all up.
So, folks, for the Patreon subscribers, this is the new TAOFLEDERMAUS beer cozy. You set your beer in there and it keeps it cold, I guess. If you set it in the fridge.
It holds.